Welcome back to another episode of 40 Facts About the 40K Universe. I am your host, Gersh One, and you are watching One Mind Syndicate. Today we continue with more viewer requests on the Minotaurs chapter. We're going to talk about their relics, their fleet, and then notable campaigns. So please, guys, suggest down below if you guys have any more Space Marine chapters that you guys would like us to create a video for. Be sure to put suggestion followed by whatever topic you guys want us to cover. Any Space Marine chapters or what have you. With that said, let's get into 40 facts about the Minotaurs. The Minotaur chapter holds many relics, one of which is the Black Spear. A deadly relic weapon of unknown province, the Black Spear is similar to some regards to the sacred arm of the Adeptus Astartes. The spear is a power weapon of remarkable potency, able to pierce even Terminator battle plates. It also incorporates a single-shot laser weapon sufficiently potent enough to be used as an anti-tank weapon if needed. The Black Spear is currently wielded by Chapter Master Austerion Moloch, and is the ceremonial badge of office for every master of the Minotaurs. Another chapter relic is the Unmaker Touch. In many chapters, the mighty Chain Fist is a weapon that is used only in the direst of conflicts, as the armor of most Battle Brothers is insufficient to bear the weight and supply the power of such a weapon. The Minotaur's great stock of Terminator armor means that they are able to bring forth such weapons more easily than most. Of the terrible weapons so mounted, few are more feared than the chain fist called Unmaker's Touch. Its potent power field makes a mockery of armor and vehicles, and has also served admirably against the creations of heretics and other unliving foes. The Minotaurs possess a mighty chapter fleet composed of no less than 12 strike cruisers and at least one battle barge at the time of the Bad App War. At the start of the Orphean War, the Minotaur's chapter fleet had expanded to consist of 3 battle barges, of which 2 were destroyed during the conflict, and 8 strike cruisers as well. The Minotaur's battle barge, Fidelitas Lamba, sacrificed itself by ramming the Necron flagship, a Cairn-class tomb ship called the Death Hand, during the climax of the Orphean War, causing substantial damage to the flagship and driving it away. The Daughter of Tempest was taken as a spoil of war from the Lamenters chapter during the Bad App War. This warship was shot asunder by a crossfire of Scythe-class harvester ships during the Orphean War. The Stymphalos was one of the warships of the Minotaur's chapter fleet that took part in the orbital phase of the Battle of Amra Prime during the Orphean War and emerged with a surprisingly small amount of battle damage for the massive void ship battle. One of the most notable Minotaur campaigns that revealed their suspicious nature occurred during the Vengeance from the Void campaign. Across 100 scattered systems in the western marshes of the Segmentum Solar, cult uprisings led by a core of Chaos Space Marine warbands drawn from the Iron Warriors, Night Lords, and World Eaters traitor legions bring entire planetary governments to their knees in a year of blood and anarchy. With the whole section on the brink of collapse, events took a dramatic turn when a combined force of the Adeptus Astartes emerged from the black depths beyond the spiral arm and launched a sudden and overwhelming attack directly upon the uprising command. Though many Space Marines fell in glory, the warlords of the traitor factions were slain and the uprising fractured into 1,000 localized rebellions, which were soon put down by local forces. Subsequent inquisitorial studies claim that these Space Marines were drawn from several chapters, including the Minotaurs, Carcharodons, Death Eagles, and Angels of Absolution. Other evidence, however, including their estimated founding and projected deployment date, contradict these assertions. In the year 425 of the 41st millennium, when the Minotaurs reappeared again for the first time in a millennia, during the suppression of the Macarian heresy, they were a chapter familiar through their fell reputation and yet profoundly changed. Equipped to the highest imperial standards, they fought as an integrated and highly flexible force and were based upon a powerful chapter fleet, operating more than 12 strike cruisers. No less brutal than their ancient reputation suggests, they fought in what was nevertheless a more considered and controlled manner than that heard in the ancient tales. During the suppression, it was the Minotaurs who formed the spearhead of the battle group, which shattered the petty star empire of the outlaw, Colonel Lyris, of the 11th Kaldu Armored Corps. their chapter's land raiders, blasting apart the famed tanks of the elite Kandusian Immortals on the icy plains of Gyro Prime. They also carried out exterminatus orders on the hive world of Duval and the sword realm of the Hope Cluster, while on the ocean world of Nereus, they hunted down and obliterated the Xenos-possessed remnants of the Imperial Paladis Chapter 4th Company in the maze of the subsurface cavern cities, poisoning the seas of this once vital agri-world. The Euxine incident was an action of which the Minotaurs gained the most infamy during the Markian Heresy, and involved the near destruction of two Imperial Space Marine chapters, the Doom Warriors and the Inceptors, who had become locked in conflict. With the two combatant chapters refusing calls to end their battle and aid with the pacification of the Markian Crusade conquered worlds, the Minotaurs were dispatched to sunder the two and end the strife. Caring nothing for the cause of rights of the two chapters, the Minotaurs attacked in full force. Overmatched and broken, the Doom Warriors fled the system almost immediately in a barely organized retreat. The remaining Inceptor Space Marines were forced into a humiliating surrender. A fewer than 100 Battle Brothers survived the Minotaurs' assault. This created friction between the Minotaurs and the Ultramarines and their successor chapters, who have sworn vengeance on the Minotaurs should the opportunity arise, and have banned them from entering the realm of Ultramar. In the year 760 of the 41st millennium, the defense of Hermetica was a noble Imperial military campaign carried out by the Minotaur Space Marine chapter against the forces of the Word Bearer's Traitor Legion on the world of Hermetica. This vital hive world was the capital of the Konman sector in the Segmentum Solar, and it came under massive assault from a vast mutant horde numbering in the millions, led by the armies of the Word Bearer's Dark Apostle, Laken the Devourer. The Chaos attack arrived from the warp rift that opened on the system's edge and was carried aboard a colossal space hulk designated the Nightmare Paradox. The planet was well protected, owing to the suddenness of the onslaught and the sheer scale of the chaotic attack. The system's outer defenses were soon overwhelmed, and the transcontinental hive cities of the planet itself swiftly became battlegrounds, on which its beleaguered defenders fought desperately against the tide of damned horrors that assailed them. In the year 760 of the 41st millennium, the Minotaur's chapter was the first outside force to respond to the planet's straggled pleas for help, and using their chapter's fleet firepower for cover, they cut off the invaders from orbit and swiftly counter-assaulted the main chaotic foothold on the planet of Hive Casabon, entering the Basilica of the Saint Lesro Antaraki. The Minotaur's assault was devastating and indiscriminate, and after a heavy bombardment of their landing zone, they smashed through the cathedral's district plaza and temples in an attack column of heavy armor, heedless of the cost in civilian lives. The Minotaur's advance was relentless, blasting apart any strong point they encountered and driving the enemy before them along with thousands of trapped civilians fleeing the carnage, but who had nowhere to run. Swiftly, the cathedral complex itself was encircled and bombarded. Its kilometer-high main spire toppled in a crossfire of turbo laser strikes from the wings of the Minotaur's Thunderhawk gunships. Into this storm of debris and ash, the Terminators and assault squads of the chapter attacked to wipe out any survivors, led by their chapter master, Moloch, at the forefront of the attack. Fighting his way into the depths of the basilica, it was Moloch who slaughtered the foul, demon-possessed bodyguards and struck a mortal blow to their hulking, toad-like master. But before the fatal stroke could be dealt to the Dark Apostle, he fled into the warp through the use of their black arts. The degenerated mutant tides fought on, but now leaderless and without direction. It was beaten back and contained until the arrival of the Imperial 17th Battle Group and Imperial Guard regiments from Necromunda, which purged the world of the Chaos taint. Deflected from its course of Nova Cannon strikes, the Hulk Nightmare Paradox, now silent, occupies a quarantine orbit in the distant reach of the star system, awaiting further detailed examination by the Grey Knights and the agents of the Adeptus Mechanicus. In the year 907 of the 41st millennium, The Minotaurs arrived in the maelstrom zone of the Ultima Segmentum, answering the direct call from the acting head Inquisitor for more Space Marines to join the Loyalist cause against the Secessionist chapters. The conflict was in its fourth year of open warfare, and the Minotaurs committed their entire strength to the war. 10 companies and 11 capital ships of various types. While the chapter coordinated their efforts with the Loyalist command, they operated largely independent throughout the conflict, striking targets as they saw fit. The viciousness of the chapter's reputation for leaving no survivors among those that resisted them quickly grew, and remained uncontested until the arrival of the even more savage Carcharodon chapter. The Minotaurs gained several important victories during this time, effectively destroying the Secessionists on multiple worlds. The action of which their fame would spread far beyond would be its wholesale defeat of the Lamenters chapter in a close-quarter Space Marine battle in the Orbita system in the closing days of the early Badab Uprising in the 908 year of the 41st millennium. Finally, the Minotaurs withdrew from the Maelstrom Zone in the year 913 of the 41st millennium, after the fall of the Badab Primus, taking with them several former Lamenters warships to replace their own losses. And finally, in the year 989 of the 41st millennium, the Minotaurs saw action on Ryan's world during the attempt to reclaim the Crimson Fist homeworld from the Orcs. And those were 40 facts about the Minotaurs. And that is the end of the Minotaurs lore. If you guys have any suggestions for more Warhammer 40k topics or any Space Marine chapters that you guys would like us to create a video for, please comment down below. Jump on over to our playlist tab and you're actually going to find a bunch of playlists of every single Space Marine chapter that we've created so far. If there's one that's not on there yet, please suggest that Space Marine chapter and we will create a video for you. And again, guys, thank you so much for letting us reach 50,000 subscribers. Of the making of this video, we're not at 50,000 subscribers yet, but I have a feeling by the time I post this, we'll be at 50,000 subscribers. So thank you guys so much. Expect a giveaway very, very soon. And again, it's because of you, and it's because of you guys sharing, liking, and commenting down below. It's because of that we can continue to give you more lore for Warhammer 40k. And of course, we're going to give you guys more stuff later on. So I'll catch you guys tomorrow. This was Gersh1 with One Mind Syndicate, signing out.